Let's start by saying, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank everyone on behalf of the bride and groom for being here today, especially to those of you who travelled the long distance. First off, I'm going to read a few cards from people who sadly couldn't make it here today. I'll start off with that. The first is from the Wrexham Argon football team. It says, congratulations on your big day, and sorry we couldn't be there. Over the years he played for us, we found John to be useless in every position. That's all luck, we haven't had more luck. The second one, to be honest, confused me a little bit. It says, dear John, I enjoyed all the days lazing by the pool together. I hope you made the right decision. All I love, Michael Barrymore. Says, my dearest John, how I've missed you in the time we've been apart. I feel empty inside as you took a part of me when you left. Although it was weird, your mum being on your stag do, it was also good to be there too. Lots of love, Victoria, aka Sticky Vicky. To speak of a man who's good looking, charming, witty, and intelligent. But I shouldn't really talk about myself. According to tradition, I meant to sing the groom's praises and tell you all about his many good points. But unfortunately, mate, I can't sing and I don't lie. I was looking for inspiration for this week's interview, so I asked everyone here to write down a few words they'd use to describe each other. Thoughtful, caring, trusting and charismatic, all kind words. Hairy, that one was Leanne. In fact, I found hardly anyone with bad things to say, but I did find a few. When I heard lazy, stubborn and obstinate, I thought, hang on, that's a bit harsh. But if your parents don't know you, they need them. Signed up for a career as a pass controller. John is petrified of anything insect-like. He's been known to wake Mum up in the middle of the night to beg her to kill a moth. He fears that he's just not used to insects either. Like the true man he is, he's scared of heights too. In fact, in Blackpool once, Jay asked him to go on the big one. John suggested the teacups. As John's younger brother, I have always walked in his footsteps. Not literally, of course. Have you seen his tasting footwear? Actually,
you brilliant man.
Actually, footwear has been a great source of stress for this wedding. I think before John decided who he wanted to marry, he decided he wanted to wear pink shoes. The only reason he's not wearing them is because he couldn't find any. There's a reason for that, mate. No one wants to buy any. John's fashion sense has been a constant source of amusement to me and Suzanne, much to the annoyance of our mum, who tells us not to pick on him because he's the sensitive one. Sorry, Mum, but if he dresses the way he does, he brings it on himself. Fair play, mate, you screwed up our item. We do share the same taste in some things though. For example, we both love McDonald's. Some more than others, the way we enough with the jokes now, it's time to be a little bit sincere. John, you're a good brother, and I'm honoured that you've asked me to be your best man. And I'm so happy that you found and married the love of your life. I know I speak for everyone in this room when I wish you a lifetime of happiness. So if everyone would like to join me in raising their glasses.